Hey guys, Becky with Design Bundles here, and I am back today with another Canva tutorial. All right, now I know we're learning right along together, and this is a feature that you guys are really going to enjoy. It is their really super awesome, totally underestimated background removing tool.
Okay guys, so you're really not gonna believe how easy this was. So I came to Canva, and this was a tool that I really wanted to play with for a long time, and I just finally made time today, but I've never had a lot of faith in background removers, so I really wasn't holding my breath for this to work. But I mean, obviously, I'm here to talk to you about it. So it worked beautifully. And I'm here to tell you why this is something that you want to use with your design bundles products or your design bundles projects that you're making for customers, things like that. So we already told you about the awesome way that you can use it with your Cricut. So this is just one more reason why I am slowly falling in love with Canva. Okay, so enough yammering on, right? Let's go to your designs. Let's see, here it goes. Now, this was just a design that I was playing with. So that wasn't what I wanted to show you. But this is where I was playing. Go to my uploads. And I uploaded several different projects that I had worked on. Okay? So what I do a lot of photo products. Okay, so this is one. This is a video. And this is kind of where it started. This is a video that I did for you guys. And I was kind of like, you know, I'd really love to showcase that better. You know, I get late night thoughts driving home, and I'm like, how could I do better? You know, maybe I need to get a background to lay the t-shirts on. Maybe I need to get a mannequin, you know, a ton of different ways that you can showcase. But sometimes you're just really limited on space. And, you know, mock-ups, they work, but do they really show your customer what a finished product will look like? If they can look at it and tell that it's a mock-up, not all customers are a fan of that. So sometimes it's really important to be able to show off your own work. So anyway, so that's kind of where my thought circle was. I was circling around those thoughts, and I came back to a background remover. You know, that way, because I have a lot of products that I've already taken photos of, and they don't always have the best background. I can't go back and retake those photos if I've already given the product away, or, you know, have worn it, and, you know, of course I'm going to spill something on it, that sort of thing. Anyway, so now that I've explained all that, let me show you how awesome this works. So I've uploaded this. So you literally go to upload media, go to device. Of course, you can hook it up to Facebook, you know, pull things in off Facebook. Let's go to some of the things that I've done for design bundles. Those are going to be in my OneDrive. My OneDrive is kind of a dump area, unfortunately. Okay, so this one is a great example, I think. So I really love this shirt. This was one of the first videos that I did for you guys on the channel. And it's just always been one of my favorites. But especially at that time, I really wasn't equipped to take, you know, professional photos. So what you're going to do is bring it in, choose effects, and click on background remover. Boom. That's it. That's literally it. Like, did you see how fast that was? Now I don't have to be embarrassed of my photo. So I'm going to bring it down here, and I can add some text up here if I want. So say this was something I was going to put in my shop. So I'm going to go to text. I'll create a heading. So of course I can change my colors up here. So I want it to be something a little bit more festive. Look guys, they match up your colors for you. I mean, like, does it get any better? Maybe, but this is still pretty awesome. Maybe I want to put the dollar amount on here, or I can say, sale 50% off. Now, I'm kind of kidding. You don't do 50% off. If you're a small business, no 50% off, you guys. Don't do it. I'm going to go to position, forward. I'm going to choose a font. This one's my new favorite font. It's called Rainbow Dreams. sale, 50% off. We're going to pretend like this was a customer that didn't show up for their order. Oh, that never happens to you guys, right? No, me either. And then, of course, what if I need a watermark on here? I can add some more text, and I'm going to say designbundles.net, right? I have to represent my design bundles. Let's make it a little smaller. I'm going to put it down here in the corner. I'm going to pick a cute little font. Now, if you have a custom logo for your business, then you don't even have to worry about that. Just make sure it comes with a transparent background and you can import it and use it. So boom, there's my watermark. Now let's talk about this background. There's a whole wide world of backgrounds here. So maybe you don't like the background. You want a different background. I played around with this one for a while. This one was kind of cool. If you want brighter colors. Not that one though. That one doesn't look good. That don't look good with the shirt. Blech, that's gross. Okay. So, ooh, this one's pretty. Oh, I wonder if they have any sunflowers. Oh no, no sunflowers. Just kidding, guys. Now remember that, like I told you in the beginning, my account is unlocked because I have already purchased the membership, but don't worry. I did pull up the information for you. Now I do not work for Canva. I'm not affiliated with Canva at all. I've just found it to be a really useful tool to use, with designs or shirts or whatever I'm using off of design bundles, right? Because a lot of times if I'm buying designs, that means I am taking full advantage of that commercial usage that comes with my design. Anyway, here we go. So there's that pro account. So it is $12.95. You can try it for free. They're going to loop you in here. But it's $12.95 and then you get all of the pro features. I've talked a little bit about that before, but just wanted to clarify some of these things are exclusive to the pro members. But can we just say that this looks a lot better than the picture of the shirt on my tile floor? That's all I'm saying. Not everybody wants to buy your shirt once they recognize that that shirt is in fact laying on the floor. Anyway, so that is one really great example. So let's talk about this. You could make your own mock-ups this way. All right, which is really, really fabulous. You could come in here and design your files like we talked about with Cricut. We talked about the Canva templates. We already have a video on that for you because certain designers on design bundles are making templates. That way you could just print them out. We did an elf adoption certificate. Really cool project. Really easy, really easy. So that's where I'm coming around to. Canva is really, really easy. But yeah, having that remove background feature just really opens up what I can do and the mockups that I can create or use, with my fabulous design bundles products. Okay. So I have droned on and on about that. Sorry about that, guys. I get really passionate when I find things that I can share with you, especially a small business owner. Okay. But let's go ahead and talk about what happens when the background doesn't work exactly like you wanted it to. Well, sometimes there's no way around that. Let's delete some of this off here. So it happened with this project of mine. I was wanting to take the background out. Now let me switch the background back to a lighter color. That'll make sense in a moment. We'll go back to the brick. Okay, and I'm going to go to effects and background remover, right? All right, so I'm going to zoom in. Let's see, let's do 75%. And do you see how, and this is what happens when you have a really busy background or a background that's not easily detectable, it doesn't make it easy that this is a white frame, okay? So Canva's kind of like, hey, what are you doing here, lady? And what I want to do is point out this red spot over here. Now, I waited too long. I said, hey, lady, you're talking too much. Let's do this again. Because you only have one shot at this. Okay. So if you click on something, Canva says, oh, your shot's gone. But that's okay. It's really easy to do. Okay. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to use this erase button. Now, you can do this to erase or restore. And I'm not saying it's super easy, but I can come in here by hand and erase that red part out of the photo. And it's certainly better than not being able to do it at all. And you can affect your brush size, okay? And then I can click over to restore if I wanted to restore part of a photo. Okay, see how it's bringing the background back? All right, so I don't really want to do that. So I would just click done, and then there we go. Now we have the background removed, and all I had to do was remove that little part by myself. So you can definitely do that and do a little touch up by hand if you need to. I want to show you one more design. This one. Now this one was already a mock-up. All right. So I'm going to hit effects and background remover, and I want you to see what happens. So it got really confused, I think, because there was so much white in the middle of the picture. Now, in theory, I could kind of get away with using this a little bit because I could erase all this outside part that I don't want, but it wasn't as easy as remove the background and it's just going to take out whatever was behind the basket, right? It picked up all that white that was in the middle, and it just got really confused. So does not always work, but that is the only picture. Oh, and then on this one, I'll show you this one too. It did not work. Now, I'm not showing you this to be disappointing because I just raved and raved and raved about what all you can use this for. but you just have to recognize that there are going to be some struggles. So it picked up the baseboard and a little bit of the floor down here. So, you know, it did really well around the flowers, but where I'm going with this is this type of program is still going to go off contrast. So when you have something that has a clear defined background, obviously that's going to be your better choice. But, you know, you can go back through, like I said in the beginning, those photos that you have and start using those. You can use them to sell your products or just kind of create yourself a little gallery. There's nothing wrong with showing off your artwork, and this is going to help you showcase it to the best of your ability. So I'm excited. I hope you guys are excited. And that's all I have for you. So let's do the wrap up.
So how did you guys feel about removing that background? Wasn't that like the easiest thing you ever discovered? Now I know that there are, I've heard that there are phone apps and different things, but you know, I'm such a computer oriented person. And the fact that I can go back and find those old photos and just take care of it all in one fell swoop, that is really attractive to me. Now, I'm not saying that you do or don't want to upgrade or you do or don't want to use Canva, but I'm really glad that you've hung out this long because this is another tool that you can file away and you can say to yourself, hey, this is something I know how to do. All right? All right, guys. Well, I appreciate you stopping by today. I appreciate you hanging out. And of course, make sure you like, share, and subscribe. That's kind of our thing. So I appreciate it when you do it, and it helps us bring you more videos. Speaking of, don't stay away for long because we always have a lot of really great videos planned for you right around the corner. Thanks again. We'll see you next time.